Once Jaymi has kissed her goodbye, leaving her alone and self-sufficient at last, the platinum raven lies listless in the heavy heat, sprawled among the long grasses in a sickly sweet-scented corner of the garden, on a stretch of earth that's so far down the steep slopes below her terrace she may never quite clamber this far down again. He has not, of course, really left her alone. In fact, he's slanting his attention back up and over the Mount Olympus hillsides towards her now, while he drives back down to the house on Electra Drive, only just noticing the fatigue she feels in her brand new body as a result of her convulsive meat space debut in the Blue Jay Way house. "Rest, my dear, rest," he murmurs aloud. Gazing sideways, the platinum raven becomes aware of something bulky behind a clump of tall grass nearby, but just beyond her reach, where wasps are hovering and dipping in the air. Wondering at it, she rolls herself a little closer and reaches out to part the clump, half fearing to reveal a corpse in lush decay. But no, it's a sizeable feast of rotting fruits that have fallen from her various fruit trees and must have been heaped up by some gardener she's not yet aware of. She cocks her ears beyond the wasps towards the house itself up the hill, where she pictures fluted columns and ruined balustrades above abandoned palace rooms. On a ballroom stage, a calliope exhales sad intervals, seeping through the terrace doors and down the garden into her. She thinks she hears a soft chime emanating from even lower down the slope, where her property ends in a thicket of vegetation that is such an awkward scramble to access she knows she will never go there. She sits up, peers in that direction, and sees a stirring of leaves and a restless waving of dead flower heads, although there's no breeze, as if an unseen attention is stalking her.